The electrons shuffling around inside our computers move pretty fast. Theoretically, their top speed in silicon is up to 100,000 meters per second. Which is good, because the faster they can move, the faster chips can do calculations, the faster I can refresh Twitter. But there will always be something faster. Light. Why don't we use photons in computers instead of electrons? We already use photons for communication. Fiber optic cables are what keep the globe's computers interconnected as they hurtle data around at light speed. But when it comes time to process that data, we convert light to electrons and run them through transistors. The conversion uses energy, and electrons are comparatively slow, so researchers are exploring how to build light-based transistors instead. Transistors are the fundamental building block of your computer's central processing unit. They're basically nanoscale switches that will either stop current or let it flow. It's important that a transistor's output can act as the input for the next transistor. Actually, it has to be able to send the current on to at least two transistors for logic signals to propagate. And it has to preserve that signal quality to keep errors to a minimum. We have made optical switches, but for one reason or another, they don't work as a replacement for the silicon transistors we use in electronics. Like, because the output signal is a different wavelength than the input, making controlling the next switch in line difficult. Or the design for the switch is too big, in the micron scale instead of the nanoscale, so gains in speed come at the expense of size. Or the design requires a cloud of supercooled atoms, which isn't exactly practical. Even though scientists have been trying since the 60s, an optical transistor that can replace an electrical one has never materialized. Like trying to build a photonic chip that mimics how a human brain performs calculations. Scientists at MIT have built a chip that uses beams of light sent through channels of silicon to mimic a neural network. The beams split and combine and travel at different speeds as the silicon is heated and cooled. Brighter beams represent bigger numbers, and as these beams split, combine, and interfere with each other, their brightness changes, effectively performing several small multiplication problems lightning fast. They've applied this photonic chip to train a neural network to understand vowel sounds, and have had modest success. They think they can improve their results dramatically by making a purpose-built system instead of the jury-rigged proof of concept they tested. But given how optical computing has historically failed to live up to expectations, skeptics aren't holding their breath. Before we see an all-light chip, we'll probably see hybrid optoelectronic systems that take advantage of light's ability to transmit data quickly across large distances. But until transistors reach their lower size limit and can't improve anymore, it looks like we'll be relying on slow old electrons to do the mathematical heavy lifting. We haven't found our way to the future of computing yet, so make sure you're ready when we finally get there by starting your very own website with domain.com. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. They can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs, from .ninja to .dog to .love. Take the first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. Why would transistors have a lower size limit? Well, you can blame quantum weirdness. Trace explains why we might one day ditch silicon here. Fun fact, there's a disagreement whether light-based computers or quantum computers are the future, but thanks to the nature of light, it's possible future computers could be both. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.